Hello and welcome. In this class, we'll be learning about Dreamweaver. So there are two basic functions of Dreamweaver. One is web designing and the second is web development. In this session, we'll be learning about web designing. So first we will learn what we are going to do in Dreamweaver. In Dreamweaver, we are going to do a web page design in which we will be using HTML. HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language. So first in Dreamweaver, we will learn the following. Second, we will learn this following. And third, we will learn the following. Means we have divided Dreamweaver into three parts and we will learn in three parts. So this is my part one. First, what I will do, I open my Dreamweaver. I get my screen like this. So then I click on HTML. Click on HTML. This is the interface of Dreamweaver. So in the olden days, web page design was done using HTML and the codings were written in this way. And we used either Notepad or WordPad to write all the coding. But with the help of Dreamweaver, you don't have to remember all the coding. You can create the coding as well as graphical design. So we will learn one by one, step by step. So first, is your code split design live? What are the four things? So here you will find the four things: code, split, design and live. So now if I click on code, so this is the code window which you are able to see. Then if I click on design, this is the design window you are able to see. If I click on live, this is the live web page, that is the output. And when I click on split here, you can see the code portion here and the live portion here. If I click on design here and code here of this live and click on split, then I can see the code section as well as the design section. Okay, so these are the portions in which we will be doing our work. Next, window workspace classic. So you have to go to window here, click on workspace layout and click on classic. So there are different kinds of layouts for different kinds of user. We will be learning with classic here. So click on classic. So after that, we will add some text. Suppose now I am in my split window. If I click here, I am able to see the mouse cursor. That means I am in the split of code and design. So here I click and I type something. Welcome to web page designing. I press enter two times, then I type here suppose class 1 and press enter two times. So now you see in the left side the code has been automatically written. So what is does this P stands for? P is a page breakup. So if I type on welcome to page designing, so here you can see welcome to page designing is written in a line. Then we have got a space bar here, then we have written something. So for doing a web page, we have to write actually all these codes. So this was taking lots of time, but nowadays with the help of Dreamweaver, you don't have to worry about the code. You just design it as you design in any graphic designing software. The codes are automatically managed. Okay. So then window workspace classic, then we have added a text. So now we will assign a font to a text. See, assigning font to a text is not easy as Microsoft Word or any other software. So first you have to create a CSS, which is called Cascade Style Sheet, and using the CSS we assign a font to the text. So let us see how we will do. So select the welcome to web page designing here. So I have selected the web page designing. So then what I do here, you have got your CSS styles, or you can see the CSS styles here. So I click on CSS. So here you have the font. Choose the font which you want to choose. Suppose I choose here Verdana. I click on Verdana font. So here it will ask to give the name to the CSS. I give the name Verdana font. Okay. Then I click on okay. Now see, this is called a CSS class. A CSS class of Verdana font has been created, with the help of which you are assigning fonts and which will be included in your codings also. Okay. So now here I have added a font. So this is how to assign a font to the text. Suppose let us take another example. I select class 1, I go to CSS, I go to fonts. See, here you have the list of fonts which are already here. You can go to edit font list and you can add a new font also. Suppose if I choose here Arial Black, give a name. It may not be Arial Black, you may give any name. Suppose I give Arial Black, okay, like this. So now this font has also been added. So now I change this. You are having the targeted rule here. So whichever rule you want to apply, you can apply that rule. Okay. So now suppose this is about adding a font. Now let us add a title. What is the title? So now you see the title is untitled document. So now I select this untitled document and I type here welcome to my space, like this. Press enter, like this. So this is the process through which we added a title here. So you can see the title here, welcome to my space. It has been added here. So now we are viewing the code window and the design window. So if I click on live, now you can see this is your live window, like this. Okay, so you can see the live window in another way also. Okay, I off the live here. Okay, so you can go to file, you can go to preview in browser and click on Chrome. First you have to save the file before viewing in browser. Suppose I click on save. I save it in a particular folder. Okay, Dreamweaver. Suppose I save it as, see, for saving the file there are some rules. Okay, so what are the rules of saving a file? You should not use any space bar and you should not use any capital letters. This will not work in your web page. Okay, so always give, suppose say web page, you can use underscroll only one. Okay, don't give any space bar or don't use any capital letters. Click on save. These are some fundamentals of web designing. So now I go to file. Oh, it is automatically opening in the browser. Now you see your file has opened in the browser. This is your title which you will get here like this, welcome to my space. And this is whatever you have written. Okay. So we have added a title. So now let us learn how to add an image in the Dreamweaver. Okay. So press enter. So here you are having some common layouts. So this we'll be learning step by step. But now I am teaching you according to the list which I have prepared here. So first let us just add an image. How to add an image? Go to the common here. So here you have got images. Click on image. So I click on image here, you choose the image. Okay. Remember one thing, the image should be in the folder in which you have saved the HTML file. If you use any other source from other places, then when you publish it, this file will not be visible to you. Okay. So now I choose an image here, suppose common, click on OK. Okay. So give an alternate text, means suppose by chance if this image is not able to download in the browser, so temporarily it will show this image, this text image common. Okay, click on OK, like this. See, the image has been inserted. Now go to file, save. Now go to file again, preview in browser, Chrome. See, now you have added a image to the web page. So instead of always going to preview in browser, you can just click on live and off the split, or you can just click on live, you can see the live design here. Okay, click on split here, off the live. Okay, so we are editing, so let us be in the editing mode now. Okay, so here we have learned how to add an image and we have saved the file. So now we will create a hyperlink to a web page. So what is hyperlink to a web page? Suppose I go here somewhere, I type here, suppose web page link. You can type anything. Suppose I type web page link and I type here Google, like this. I just type one word, Google here. So then what I do, I select this Google here. I go to common. Your first option is hyperlink. Click on hyperlink. Okay, so the text is Google, so you can targeted to suppose somewhere here. So here you can type the link here. Suppose if I type here http semicolon double slash www.google.co.in. Okay, like this. So now I save the file, file, save. Now I go to file, preview in browser, Chrome. Okay, so now this is my web page. Now you can see that web page link and Google. Now if I go over Google here, so it will link to google.coin page. So now the net is disconnected, so you are not able to see here. Otherwise this has been linked to this page. So this is the part one, basics of Dreamweaver. So no, we have another two things left: create a button with rollover image and creating a table. Okay, so what is a button? Suppose if I want to create a button design here, okay, suppose if I open you have to open Photoshop here. Okay, so I go to Photoshop. So I open my Photoshop, go to file, new. Okay, suppose create some image here, suppose say 60 pixels by say 40 pixels, or say 90 pixels by 40 pixels RGB. Keep it as transparent. Okay, so now this is a button which I want to create. Okay, a small button here. I create a design like this. Okay, you can give any color to it. You can add some design effects like layer style. Okay, suppose if I add a bevel and emboss here, which will look like a button. Okay, I add a color overlay here. I need some kind of color like this. Okay, bevel and emboss, increase a little bit the depth. Okay, okay. Now I go to text. I click on the text. Click somewhere outside, write the text here. Suppose if I write submit, move and place it over it. Okay. So I have created my button here like this. So next, what I do, I create a duplicate layer of this rectangle using Ctrl J, duplicate layer. Okay, now I just change the color of it, color overlay, and I change it to suppose this color. Okay, okay. So now what I do, I go to file, save as. You save as a PNG file. Okay, and that too in the same folder, PNG file, save it in the same folder where you have placed your HTML file, Dreamweaver. Here I have, suppose I give it B1. Okay, okay. Now I off this rectangle with this color, file, save as, same PNG file. Okay, save it as B2. Okay, okay. Now I have saved two files. Now go to Dreamweaver. Now go over here. Click on rollover image. This is a button. Okay, suppose if I say this is my linking button, I click on original image. In original image I use suppose B1, and rollover image I click on B2, and I can give an alternate text here. Suppose say I write here submit, and I go to URL, suppose www.google.co.in. See, using browser we can link some internal files also, that I will teach further. Click on OK. Now I go to file, save. So instead of always going to preview in browser, I just click on live here. Okay, so just go to the bottom and you see, when I take my mouse over, my button is changing. So this is how you can create your button of your own or I can just check it in preview in browser also. Like this. Okay, I go over submit, click on submit. This will redirect to google.co.in. Okay, close it. Okay, so what is remaining? Creating tables. So now we can create tables in this also. So how to create a table? So you can go to insert here. Okay, in insert you have got table. I click on table. So computer will ask number of rows, number of columns. So 3 rows 3 columns. Okay, nice. Tables are very useful because we can create our design completely in the tables. Okay, suppose if I type here ABCEFG. Okay, so this is very easy form to maintain your subject. Okay, this is how to create tables. You can select two tables and merge together. I select both of them together. Okay, I select both of them together. So there are lots of options when I click on right click. Okay, like aligning, giving the font styles, templates. Okay, and all like this. Can go to modify table. You have got merge cells here. Click on merge cells. Okay, so now these two cells have become one row. So this I will explain it in detail when I will create a practical of web page. So this is how tables are created and layouts are done. Okay, so this is your first part of Dreamweaver. I have explained you to create all these things. So create this file and save it. This you have to submit at the end of the class. So save the file. So file, save. This is my class 1. Thank you.